and smile, 'cause it's been a while. It's been like a whole day since I stopped so you could hold me. But this child awaits, strong in the faith. Lord, you are the refuge that I can't wait to get to, 'cause I can't let a day go. Can't let a day go by without thanking you for the joy that you bring to my life. And it's a beautiful day. Yeah, it's a beautiful day. When trouble seems to rain on my dreams, it's not a big deal. Let it wash all the bugs off my windshield, 'cause you're showing me that in you I'm free, and you're still the refuge that I've just to get to, so I won't let a day go, won't let a day go by. So put the drop top down, turn it up, I'm ready to fly. And ooh, there's something about the way your sun shines on my face. It's a love so true, I can never get enough of you. This feeling can't be wrong, I'm about to get my worship on, take me away. It's a beautiful about. There ain't no limitations to your amazing grace, your amazing grace. And there's something about the way your love shines on my face. Oh no, I can never get enough of you. This feeling can't be wrong, I'm about to get my worship on. I'm gonna sing a brand new song, yeah.
it's time for honesty. My heart is on my sleeve, or will you hear me out? I've got nothing left to give of me. I gave up everything, so there is nothing left to lose for me now. Would you forgive me somehow? Chased a million things, bright lights and empty dreams. Now here I am, right where I thought I wanted to be. I'll trade it all right now, leave it home and lay it down to get back to where I belong. Lord, all I've ever needed was your love. Made this world my home. I let it steal my soul, but now I want it back. 'Cause all I need is waiting in your arms, a place to hang my heart, where I am known at last. You're the one true thing.
His mercy is unfailing. His arms a fortress for the weak. Let faith arise. Let faith arise. I lift my hands to believe again. You are my refuge. Tree. washes over me. Let faith arise.
Sing it out, yeah. Oh, to satisfy my thirst, to love me at my worst. And even when I don't remember, you remind me of my word. I don't trust my ways, I'm trading in my faults. I lay down everything, 'cause you're all
say thank you, Lord, just for loving me. I, many times I do forget every need that you have met. Oh, thank you, Lord, I know you're showing me. You are there when I am down and out. You're holding me. Your love is so amazing. Here I am, with all I have, raise my hands to worship you. I wanna say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, thank you. For everything, for who you are. You cover me and touch my heart. I wanna say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
I could have died in my sin, but you saved me. Divine strength to carry on.
To attend church online. Get up, fix your bed, and get dressed. It will position you better for worship. Gather together as a family. Focus, avoid multitasking, worship as a family. Stream to your largest screen. It will feel like you're there. Sing and dance along. It might feel awkward, but God asks us to sing aloud and dance in worship. Engage and respond. Say amen, take note, bring the full worship experience at home.
Hey there! Is today your first time here? Or maybe your first time in a while? If so, maybe you're wondering exactly who we are and what this church is all about. Well, we'd like you to know that we're a group of ordinary people who are on an amazing journey together, following Christ. Our guide is the Bible because it's the divinely inspired Word of God, and it will never take us in the wrong direction. Along the way, we hope you'll see that we are welcoming and spiritually passionate, and that getting to know you is a big deal to us. We know that the road is rough sometimes, but we'll work really hard to bring you practical and relevant messages to equip and encourage you through life's ups and downs. We want you to know that we care about this community, and we believe that it's our job to make it a better place. So, no matter who you are or where you've been, we're glad you're here with us today. And we hope that you'll join us on our journey, following Christ and living out His plan for us. So, welcome to church.
Take me deeper than Good afternoon, Church. For tithes and offering, I will be sharing two reminders from the book of Proverbs. First, in chapter 3, verses 9 to 10. Honor the Lord with your wealth, with the first fruit of all your crops. Then your barns will be filled to overflowing, and your vats will brim over with new wine. This is just a reminder that even at this difficult time, we need to honor God through our giving. Lahat naman po tayo yung nakaka-experience ng kahirapan. May iba na wala ng trabaho, karamihan patuloy pa rin sa pagsiservisyo. As Christians, may we always put God first. He will stay and forever faithful to us, kahit sa kahirapan o sa kasiyahan. May we honor His word and be faithful to Him through our giving. Second, even we are experiencing this hardship, there are more people who was hit harder than us. May we extend our hands to them. As said in Proverbs 11:25, a generous person will prosper. Whoever refreshes others will be refreshed. As Christians, we are generous because we have a God who is generous. In our own very simple way, we could help. We could choose a family where we could share our blessing or be involved in community outreach. You could also ask our church leaders on the programs of how we could help others. As we are on an enhanced community quarantine, the church have opened an avenue for us to still drop our offering via our SGCM e-giving. You could fund transfer to our BPI account and GCash as flashed in the screen. And don't forget to send your proof of transaction and especially your prayer request to your leaders or any of the finance team member. The church is always praying for you. Come with me in prayer, Church. Heavenly Father, we offer unto you our tithes and offering. May this provision be extended to those who need Jesus in their lives, especially in this crisis. We also need to reach more communities, O Lord. And may your workers as well be sustained in their daily needs as they will be bearers of your gospel in this season. I pray, O Lord, for protection for our provision. We bind any schemes of the enemy that may devour our properties, our businesses, and our work. Our faith will not be shaken by this pandemic because we have a God who is bountiful provider. Lord, we also pray for those who are in need, daily food in their table. Send them help from their families, from their friends, as well as from the government. We pray, O Lord, that none of us will experience and suffer hunger, and we will be full physically and most importantly, spiritually. We also call for faithfulness and giving for your people. May we always honor you with our wealth. You will just open the floodgates of heaven and fill us with a bountiful provision. And these provisions as well will be shared to others. In this season, O Lord, may our generous heart be an extension of God to those who are in need and to those who are crippled in fear, and we stand to be like Jesus. Wisdom, physical strength be also our portion. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
General quarantine na. Nakalabas ka na ba? Para sa ating mga minor, sa ating mga senior na nanonood, sa ating mga pregnant, and sa mga sickly, stay at home po muna. I am Daryl Jane Barrios, one of the full-time workers of Sea Gentiles for Christ Ministry in the leadership of our senior pastor, Ronald Bilang. I am blessed and privileged na ako yung magsashare ng Word of God ngayong hapon. Yes, God has something for all of us this afternoon. Kaya wag mong i-exit to dahil hindi aksidente na na-click mo or nakita mo ito sa newsfeed mo. God has something for you this afternoon. In Matthew chapter 8, I hope you have your Bible with you, no? Going back, in Matthew chapter 8, in the region of Gadarenes, there is a recorded story of Jesus healing two demon-possessed men. These men were so violent that no one could pass in that way where they are. Isa po sa mga palatandaan ng taong possessed ay pagiging violente. Kaya bantay-bantay po sa mga violent people. These demons knew Jesus and begged that if they'd be driven out, they'd rather be sent to the swines or pigs. To which Jesus said, "Go." So they came out of the two demon-possessed men and went into the pigs, and around 2,000, yes, around 2,000 pigs jumped down the steep hillside and nalunod po sila. Let's read Matthew chapter 8, verses 33 to 34. The herdsmen fled to the nearby town, telling everyone what happened to the demon-possessed men. Then the entire town came out to meet Jesus, but they begged him to go away and leave them alone. Highlight natin yung part na yun. They begged him to go away and leave them alone. In other translation, it says, they pleaded with him to leave the region. They pushed Jesus out of that region. You know one thing about God? He's a gentle God. Hindi niya ipipilit kung saan hindi siya welcome. So I hope you welcome the Lord sa inyong mga tahanan ngayong hapon, sa inyong mga puso. From Gadarenes, Jesus went to Capernaum, where may ginawa siyang another na miracle, and that is the healing of the paralyzed man. Now, compare the reaction we had earlier dito sa Capernaum. In Matthew chapter 9 verse 8, no, balikan natin yung sinabi natin kanina sa Matthew chapter 8 muna, where we highlight, they begged him to go away and leave them alone. But now look at Matthew chapter 9 verse 8, kung saan Jesus healed the paralyzed man. Fear swept through the crowd as they saw this happen. And they praised God, highlight, and they praised God for giving humans such authority. The message this afternoon is inspired by these highlighted texts, sa Matthew 8 and sa Matthew 9. Both groups experienced the miracle of Jesus, the potential power of what else he can accomplish in their town. Yet, their responses were opposite. One group begged Jesus to leave, while the other praised God for what Jesus did. Ladies and gentlemen, this afternoon, we will ask a question, a very personal subject matter that requires our honesty as we wrestle. So yes, I invite you to wrestle with a question, our title. How far have you let God in? Shall we pray before we continue? Bow down your head wherever you are this afternoon. Go ahead, bow down your head and close your eyes. Huwag mong isipin yung katabi mo. Huwag mong isipin kung nasaan ka, just to welcome the presence of the Lord this afternoon. Yes, oh God. This is our expression, Lord, of our welcoming you. We invite you, Lord, right where we are right now. This becomes a holy ground. Your presence envelopes us, our home, our household, our family, our city, our barangay, O God. And Lord, as we listen to your word, you are welcome, O God, to change our views, correct our perspective. And Lord, that we will know you more. Take your place, O God, and reign. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. How far have you let God in? Ngayong hapon, I am inviting you to interact. Kung hindi mo pa natag ang iyong mga friends, go ahead. Balikan natin ang first group sa Matthew chapter 8, verse 34. Then the entire town came out to meet Jesus, but they begged him to go away and leave them alone. What attracted them to meet Jesus? The miracle of healing for the demon-possessed men. Yet the reason that called for their attention towards Jesus was the same reason that they begged him to go away and leave them alone. Well, hindi matatanggal ang bias ko or bias mo kung nabasa na natin to dahil kilala na natin si Jesus, no, sa ngayon. I get to question, bakit ganun ang reaction nila? Number one, ang Jesus na kilala natin ngayon ay nagpapakilala pa lang sa time nila. But background study, commentaries help give us or gives us the number to reason. Sa region na to ng Gadarenes, negosyo ang mga baboy. Kinakain, binibenta. Though it was not a practice among the Jews. There were 2,000 pigs ang nadamay. Galing dun sa 2 demon-possessed men. Gaano kaya kadami yun? And these pigs na tumalon dun sa hill, nalunod, they became useless. Namatay, hindi mabenta, hindi makain. In other words, lugi po ang negosyo. So the miracle that brought healing to the 2 demon-possessed men now posts a threat in their way of living. How far have you let God in? Is it, number one, as far as it is comfortable? Pag comfortable, go lang tayo, basta comfortable lang. How far have you let God in? These people in the region of Gadarenes viewed Jesus as someone who can bring them more harm than good. It was good to have this demon-possessed man healed, but it was harmful for the pigs. It was harmful for the business. It was harmful for their living. Sa panahon po natin ngayon, ang estimated loss ng 2,000 pigs na yon, nasa 3.5 to 4 million po. Ang laki nang nawala dun sa mga may-ari ng mga baboy na yon. It was comfortable na yung dating lugar na hindi madaanan ng mga tao, dahil may mga bayolenteng tao, ngayon ay pwede nang madaanan. That's comfortable. But if that comfort brings harm to our way of living, how far would you let God in? These men chose swine over the Savior, the material over the spiritual. It could even be said that they chose pigs over people, na mas mabuti na siguro yung sa dalawang tao lang kaysa sa loss of 2,000 pigs at naapektuhan ang kanilang way of living. So how far have you let God in? Is it as far as it is comfortable? The man named Daniel faced a situation that is not comfortable at all. Let us examine his choices and dig what we can learn background story muna tayo, no? Mahaba-haba pa ito pagbasahin, but I hope you have your Bible with you, no? You can just read this again later. Sa panahon ni King Darius, while exiled ang Judah sa Babylon, there was Daniel, nagkaroon ng law. May law na na-decree kung saan for the next 30 days, hindi pwedeng mag-pray kahit kaninong Diyos or tao maliban kay King Darius. So during their time, they believe no na ang kanilang hari is a god, small letter G. So walang sinuman ang pwedeng mag-pray kahit kanino for the next 30 days kay King Darius lamang. Kung sino man ang lalabag, ano yung sabi? Itatapon sa den of lions. Kung ikaw si Daniel, may favor ka sa hari, at the same time, supervisor ka ng high offices ng 120 provinces, at may plano pa si King Darius na gawin kang overseer ng entire empire. Pero ngayon, hindi mo pwedeng i-exercise ang faith mo for the next 30 days. What would you do? It's like you will be assured of a great position. Pero overtime ka kahit Sunday. Kasi grabe ka demanding ang work. O di kaya, mawawalan ka ng oras sa small group. Hindi mo na mabibigyan ng time ang iyong caring circle, ang iyong discipleship group, kasi kailangan palaging pag pinatawag ka ng trabaho, talagang dapat sisipot ka, and linggo man yan, o prayer meeting man yan, o kahit nasaan ka man. Well, I'm not talking about outside Philippines, no, kasi ibang-ibang araw yon ang kanilang pagsamba. I'm talking about Philippine setting. What would you do? What would you choose? Let's see how Daniel responded in Daniel chapter 6, verse 10. But when Daniel learned that the law had been signed, so yung decree ngayon, sealed na siya, he went home and knelt down as usual. Highlight that part, as usual, in his upstairs room, with its windows open toward Jerusalem. He prayed 3 times a day, just as he had always done. Highlight that part again, just as he had always done, giving thanks to God. Ano yung mga hinighlight natin? As usual. Just as he has always done. Give us these two phrases, give us one word, consistency. There was drastic change in the situation, yet in his faith, it was not a destruction. Let me just repeat that. There was a drastic change in the situation, yet in his faith, it was not a destruction. Ito nangyayari sa atin ngayon, drastic. Walang naging handa sa atin. But this is not a destruction to our faith. You agree? Comment your emotion, your views, your reaction to that. Do you see this as a destruction to your faith? Do you see this na maghihinder sa ating spiritual growth? You may type your answer in our comment box. Daniel chose to be consistent rather than to be comfortable. Pakinggan niyo to. Kung kausap natin si Daniel, no? Daniel naman, 30 days lang! 30 days lang! Do you see the invitation to compromise? hindi isang taon, hindi lifetime, 30 days lang! 30 days lang na hindi mo i-exercise ang faith mo! Ano lang ba naman yung 30 days? Baka nga yung iba dyan, half year nang hindi nagde-devo eh. Bato-bato po sa langit ang tamaan mag-repent. But for Daniel, and I would like to declare for many, sabihin mo, isa ako dyan sa many. We share this verse of the psalmist saying, better is one day in God's court than 1,000 elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of the wicked. Kung may rason ka na hindi i-exercise ang faith mo, igagrab mo ba ito? You see, quarantine is a very good reason not to exercise our faith. Quarantine is a very good reason to keep distance. Sana po sa panahon ng quarantine, social distancing lang ang ino-observe mo, hindi spiritual distancing. Kung nag-a-agree ka, type mo nga sa comment box natin, no to spiritual distancing. No to spiritual distancing. At para sa mga katulad ni Daniel, na pipiliin maging consistent kahit may rason mag-compromise. The result? Welcome to the den of lions. That's the result for choosing God. That's the result na hindi nag-agree at sumunod si Daniel sa dinikre ni King Darius. Is it comfortable to be with people pa lang na lion in character, eh kabahan ka na. Ito pa kayang totoong lions na anytime nako pwede kang lapain. His life was at stake. Ganun ka-opposite ng pagiging comfortable ang naranasan ni Daniel. Reading the Bible, we know na ligtas si Daniel. Mabuti sana kung every time we choose God over comfort ay maliligtas tayo tulad ni Daniel. Hindi man siguro every time, no? Pero there is something extraordinarily divine that takes place whenever we choose God. Allow me to repeat that. Hindi man siguro every time na ililigtas tayo sa isang sitwasyon when we choose God. Pero there is something extraordinarily divine that takes place whenever we choose God. Church, it is impossible to fully experience the joy of the destination when you did not go through the difficulty of the process. Kaya nga masaya ang graduation kasi sa wakas, yung mga sleepless nights, nagbunga rin. Andun yung difficulty ng process, kaya masaya ka sa nakakamit mo sa dulo. That's why success is sweet because there were many failures along the way. Ganun din sa intimacy natin with God. Many things happened along the way. So every time we get to go deeper with the Lord, hindi madali yun. Maraming pinagdaanan yun. My friend, if palagi mong pipiliin yung komportable ka lang, mahirap mong maranasan ang lalim ng kaligayahan na kahit sa hirap, pwede palang maramdaman. Listen to this carefully. To fully know God is to truly experience discomfort. If you have been comfortable since the time you profess that Jesus is your Lord and Savior, perhaps, just perhaps, or maybe not perhaps, you have not yet fully embraced the reality of your faith. When you welcome God in your life, it begins to be uncomfortable. Why? Kasi dati, okay lang man, may problema ako sa'yo, may problema ka sa akin, basta dili lang ta magtagbo, bye! Kung nasa ang kantin ka, pag nauna ka at nakita ko nandun ka, dilipat na ako ng kantin. May galit ka sa kapwa mo, mahirap magpakumbaba. Pag walang Diyos sa buhay mo, komportable lang yan. May hawak-hawak ang bigat sa puso mo na ayaw mo talagang bitawan. Ah, dili, Diyod ko, kalimot ka tong sa una. Kung wala kang Diyos sa buhay mo, komportable lang yan. Pero kung ikaw yung tao that you profess Jesus is the Lord of your life, Jesus is the Savior of your life, things like that cannot be comfortable anymore. Nalilinis yan. And so, the holiness of God, we're always told, and the sinfulness of man, palaging in opposition. Kung ang Diyos na pinagsisilbihan mo ay comfort and happiness lang ang offer sa'yo, walang thorns, walang cross, walang pain, walang fire, baka ikaw ang Diyos ng buhay mo. Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verse 11 says, "The words of the wise are like cattle prods, painful but helpful." Ganun yung words ng mga disciples natin, no? Alam natin, masasakit minsan, pero nakakatulong. So how far, my friend, how far have you let God in? Just as I hope na sana hindi ang una, which is as far as it is comfortable, I also hope na hindi itong pangalawa, as far as it is beneficial. In Acts chapter 8, verses 12 to 13, "But now the people believed Philip's message of good news concerning the kingdom of God and the name of Jesus Christ. As a result, many men and women were baptized. Then Simon himself believed and was baptized." Highlight natin yon. "Then Simon himself believed and was baptized. He began following Philip wherever he went, and he was amazed by the signs and great miracles Philip performed." Sino ba si Simon? In Acts chapter 8 verses 9 to 11, kikilalanin natin siya. "A man named Simon had been a sorcerer there," in Samaria po ito, "for many years, amazing the people and claiming to be someone great. Everyone from the least to the greatest often spoke of him as the great one, the power of God. They listened closely to him because for a long time he had astounded them with his magic." So si Simon ay isang sorcerer. Si sorcerer na Simon eventually naniwala sa shiner ni Philip at nagpabaptize. And ang sabi sa verse 13, "He began following Philip wherever he went, and he was amazed by the signs and great miracles Philip performed." However, as the story continued, it was exposed na itong si Simon the sorcerer ay iba ang motibo. When Peter and John, the apostles, laid their hands on the new believers of Samaria, the Holy Ghost came upon these new believers. And Simon the sorcerer witnessed that. Simon the sorcerer was amazed of that. Now, observe what he said to John and Peter in verses 18 to 19. When Simon saw that the Spirit was given when the apostles laid their hands on people, he offered them money to buy this power. Let me have this power too, he explained, so that when I lay my hands on people, they will receive the Holy Spirit. Remember, Simon is a sorcerer. May mga magical powers siya na naa-amaze at nagugulat din yung mga tao sa Samaria. At nakita niya ngayon, ay mas malalaki ang powers ng mga apostles. Mas makapangyarihan ang mga apostles. So, there nakita ang motive that he actually wanted only that power. Simon followed Jesus as far as it was beneficial for him. Power. What else? What else was for his benefit? The benefit of status retention. Remember that he was held highly in this area. Simon the sorcerer wanted the status of being respected without embracing the truth. As far as it was beneficial for him, he'd follow Jesus. Remember, he was baptized and followed Philip everywhere. Posible pala na nag-profess na I believe in Christ, baptized, and then hindi pala talaga totoo. Posible. We just read it. But it's not for us to judge the matter. Eventually, it is for God to expose the heart. In Acts chapter 8, verses 20 to 22, ito na ang rebuke ni Peter. Sabi niya kay Simon the sorcerer, "May your money be destroyed with you for thinking God's gift can be bought. You can have no part in this, for your heart is not right with God. Repent of your wickedness and pray to the Lord. Perhaps He will forgive your evil thoughts. For I can see that you are full of bitter jealousy and are held captive by sin." In verse 24, look at the response of Simon the sorcerer. Instead na mag-repent, ang sabi niya, "Pray to the Lord for me that these terrible things you've said won't happen to me." Takot lang pa rin sa power. Takot lang pa rin yung anong pwedeng mangyari sa kanya. There was really no genuine returning to God. Was there repentance? He was only afraid. He wanted the power. He was afraid. Another example we can find is in John chapter 6. After Jesus fed the 5,000. Anong pinag-uusapan natin? How far did you let God in? As far as it is comfortable? As far as it is beneficial. Nandito tayo ngayon. Now, tingnan natin, itong sa John chapter 6, no? This was after Jesus fed the 5,000. Sabi sa verses 25 to 26, they found him, itong mga sumusunod kay Jesus, no? They found him on the other side of the lake and asked, "Rabbi, when did you get here?" Sabi ni Jesus, ang reply ni Jesus, "I tell you the truth. You want to be with me because I fed you, not because you understood the miraculous signs." Highlight, because I fed you. You want to be with me because I fed you. Amazingly, Jesus dealt with them in the manner they would understand. Food. They followed Jesus for the benefit of provision. And Jesus told them, verse 27, "But don't be so concerned about perishable things like food. Spend your energy seeking the eternal life that the Son of Man can give you. For God the Father has given me the seal of His approval." Here we see that when God feels our need, He is actually establishing that there is more that we need. Not just perishable, but eternal. For even when we are satisfied with the perishable, we are not truly satisfied unless we receive what only the Son of Man can give. Verse 35 of the same chapter says, Sir, sabi ng mga sumusunod kay Jesus, give us that bread every day. Verse 36, Jesus replied, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry again. Whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. When God fills our need, it is an invitation for us to realize that He is all that we need. Fast forward tayo, verse 61. Jesus was aware that His disciples were complaining. So He said to them, Does this offend you? Does this offend you? How far have you let God in? If you read something in the Word of God, if you hear something through the Word of God, and it confronts your way of living, your manner of decision making, and you are offended, what do you do with that offended feeling? Do you walk out and leave it? Anyway, it's not beneficial anymore. It's not the reason I signed up for this. Or confront and accept that truth. May we be like Peter who replied, Lord, to whom would we go? You have the words that give eternal life. How far have you let God in? I hope it is number 3. As far as it is God glorifying. Ang pinakahalimbawa natin ay walang iba kundi si Jesus. He who said that, Father, kung pwede lang that this cup will be taken away from me, but not my will, your will be done. Bago na yun sinabi doon sa Garden of Gethsemane, He already mentioned the same or similar statement in John chapter 6 verse 38 saying, For I have come down from heaven to do the will of God who sent me, not to do my own will. For I have come down from heaven to do the will of God who sent me, not to do my own will. Whose will? Ang ginagawa natin for the followers of Jesus, I am talking to you. When you make a decision, where is it anchored? Do you decide based on need? Based on comfort? Benefit? Do you decide based on personal desire? Shouldn't our decision be based on obedience, because in our obedience, it is the Lord, our God, who is glorified. And this is really easily said. There's always a conflict between my will and God's will, my comfort, my benefit, my happiness, or God's truth. Or God's glory. So how far have you let God in? Is it as far as it is comfortable? As far as it is beneficial? Or as far as it is God glorifying? Kahit saan man ito, Lord, for as long as this will glorify you, I am following you, I am obeying you, bring this on. It's not gonna be easy. It's never gonna be easy. But the Lord is your strength. Our strength. Blaise Pascal puts it this way. People almost invariably arrive at their beliefs not on the basis of truth, but on the basis of what they find attractive. How far have you let God in? Are there still areas in our life na off-limit kay Lord? I hope that this afternoon led us to all the more ponder the Lordship of God, specifically the Lordship of Jesus in our life. And so, as we come to an end ngayong hapon, let's not immediately answer, how far have I let God in? But let's wrestle with it. Let's ask God to expose it in our hearts and experience a deeper intimacy with Him. So for our discussion sa ating mga caring circle and small group, or you can send this to your accountable partners, you just answer the question, how far have you let God in? How far have you let God in? At bakit ganun ang iyong kasagutan? Shall we bow our head and pray? We commit to you, Lord, what we received this afternoon. Holy Spirit, your word has been spoken and received. It's now your turn as we individually ponder. I declare blessings upon everyone. Your glory, your fame, and your honor. That is our desire, O God. Your glory, as you are our God and our King. Lord, take over in every area of our life. May the love of the Father, expressed through the Lord Jesus Christ to His grace Himself, and the ever-sweet fellowship with the Holy Spirit be the portion of everyone watching, listening, and pondering on this. Amen, and God bless us all.
To reveal